accessible to the fish. Pull it apart a little bit. Just get ready to toss her back out there. It's starting to rain. Oh, he just went straight to it. He bonked it and backed off. Maybe he'll come back. Maybe. He wants it. He's hitting it. Alright. I just gotta let it chill out. There's so many fish. So many fish just want it so bad. Oh. Got one. Come here. Yes, baby, no skunk today. Let's go. That's a fish in the net. Fish in the net, baby. Hey, look at that. Nice. Let's let him go. Hell yeah. Let's see if we can get one more. Well, I'm fishing for dinner. I let that guy go because I want a little bit bigger. A little bit bigger of a fish. But if that's all we get, then that's going to suck. But at least, hey, I'm happy. At least I caught a fish today. I was so worried that I wasn't going to catch a fish. That I bought worms so I could catch a fish. I could make sure of it. I haven't caught fish in the past what? Probably 8 times now? Eight outings of fishing. At least 2 hours apiece with no fish. And I just caught a fish. That felt good. And I netted him in my new net, which is also a double awesome. Oh, man. I just missed another one. Alright. Pretty good. You like that quick net action I had? I just ripped that puppy off my bag. Man, I'm right on Charleston Creek. I'm right by the ball fields. Oh man, I suck. I did it again. Oh, I just saw him dart back for it though. He came back for it. No. One more throw. Alright, that's it. Come on, fish. Give me a fish. Alright. We gotta move down there as quick as we can. Wind's starting to pick up. Starting to thunder more. Hell yeah. But it's still, though it's raining and thundering and shitty, it is still about like 60 degrees, which is lovely. Lovely temperature to be wet, 60 degrees. Thundering a little bit, so still gonna be cautious. Get some line out here. We're gonna just throw in the hole everybody fishes in, you know, when they first come down in here. Real quick cross the water. Dude, my luck, I'd get fucking smacked again with big old jolt. Electricity. Really hoping that doesn't happen. Really hoping. Perfect. Just as I walk down here, those sticks decide to start floating into the damn hole. Right down from the ball fields. I can just hear kids all yelling, come on, come on. They're all mad. I bet their game's getting might have to just abandon it. Abandon the hope of a fish for dinner. I think I have a fillet that I can. I think it's pretty much thawed out. I pulled it out of the freezer a couple days ago, so we'll see. Got a fish. Got a fish. Let's go. Let's go, baby. Don't lose him, don't lose him, don't lose him, don't lose him. Get the net, get the net, get the net. Get in the net. Yes, let's go.
All right. My camera died. And I'm catching fish, so I don't want to walk back to my car and risk not catching any more fish. So I'm gonna record on my phone for a little bit and see what's up. I don't know if my camera caught it, but I got this guy, and as you can see, his head's crushed. Because that's how I prefer to kill the fish I'm gonna keep. I don't like to leave them on stringers for too long, and I actually didn't bring my stringers, so insta kill. He's dead. He's dead and gone. He's gonna be dinner. I got a worm rigged up here with, you know, the sinker, because I'm still trying to catch fish. Build my confidence. And water's too muddy for flies anyways, so you know, that's what's going on. Throwing them out there by hand. I just missed a pretty nice one because I didn't have my net on me. So it might come right back and hit it again. We'll see. That's my casting method. A little toss. Because I'm using a worm and a fly rod. There's not really a great way to do it when there's trees all above you. Something wants it. It's getting attention to me. Oh, no way. Drop my vape in the water. That sucks. Nice, right along the fence. That's what I meant to do. Alright, I just moved upstream a little bit. I'm still at the same hole I caught the fish in. I'm just up at the higher section. So, everywhere I go, I keep finding people leaving line everywhere. Like, just like yards and yards and yards of fishing line. And I just want to say it's not that hard to pick that shit up. Like, watch. Let me demonstrate real quick. See this bullshit right here? Caught in a tree. Even better. Look. Simple as this. You find the end of it, right? You find any old stick. A little one works good. Put a loop in it. And just start wrapping. It takes a little bit of time, but not enough time that it should be that bothersome to anybody. You know, like, if you're out fishing or walking your dog or whatever you're doing, and you see this, pick it up. Just pick it up. I'm sorry that people do this, but it's a uncommon, or it's a unfortunate, happening all the time, everywhere, literally anywhere there's water and people maybe fish, there's going to be clusters and clusters and clusters of line. All right, look at that. Look at that. What did it take me, a minute and a half? And you just take that shit, you know? Put it in your pocket. Throw it out when you get home. Jesus Christ. All right, now that I'm done picking up other people's trash, let me get to fishing. Floating down. It's always annoying when you can see fish swimming around right in front of you, but you aren't getting anything. Right as I say that, I start to get bit. There it is, there it is, there it is. Nice one, nice one, nice one. Come on, baby, come on, baby. No time for the net, hell yeah. That's a fish right there. Let's get this hook out of him. Good fish. About the length of my net. Whoop, whoa, whoa there, buddy. Whoa there, buddy. I'll get you back, I'll get you back. Let's just look here. Keep him on the inside. Right there. I'll measure him in a second.
Off you go. And he's gone.
Alrighty, we got another worm hooked on. And we're gonna go for fish number four. I'm having a grand old time. Got that other guy back. I measured the net out. It was It was about a 14 inch trout. Not bad at all, baby. Let's go. See if we can grab another one on our little gas station slave worms. Literally, the slogan on the cooler says, "Our worms are born to catch fish or die trying," and I think that's just hilarious. Can't believe my vape's still working after I dropped it in the water over there. That's where the fish are at, right there. Got my net on me though, it's right here, so now I'll actually be able to land it if I hook into another one. I won't have to drag him up onto the mud. That was a good fight though. Normally when I do that thing where like I'm pulling him one way, but then I need to get him to go the other way and I switch the pull around real fast, you know, like shoo. That's a maneuver where I lose a lot of fish. So I'm glad that one was hooked good or whatever. Whoa! Damn! Whoa! Whoa there! Whoa! I'm stuck in the tree! I'm stuck in the tree! Yes! Let's go! Through the tree and everything! Alright, no, the fish! I got him, I got him, I got him, I got him. Get in the net! Ugh. Fish number four! Another nice little bow. This one's probably only like about 12 inches or so. I'm gonna have to mark that out on my net, the inches, but hell yeah, fish number four, gonna put them back in there. Let's go. Yeah, we're going for fish number five
out of Charleston Creek. We're right behind the ball fields for the little kitties. I don't know. Not the Wazda fields, but ball fields by the old factory, the old Osram factory. If you're local and you know where that's at. The bite is on, baby. The bite is on. Hook sets are solid. Fish are fishy.
All right, this is definitely my last stop. I'm just gonna plop it in right there along the edge of this tee right here, this cement tee. And I might drop it down in there a couple times as well, down at where it's built out. But
let me walk across there and throw it on the opposite side.
Whoa, that was scary.
I'm just getting caught on other people's line that they don't clean up. Look at this. Look at this. This is ridiculous. I'm just pulling this shit in. Look. This is my worm right there. All caught up in a bunch of shit that nobody wants to clean up. So yet again, let me just take care of this shit for everybody who's a lazy piece of trash. Thinks it's all right to leave garbage like this laying everywhere.